standard our panel, we're using a DA with 400 grit. And then we're using a refinishing pad for all the corners, or for all the edges. And then after we do that, we'll wax and degrease it. And to do that, we get a wet towel and then a dry towel and wipe it dry, just so we don't got any debris still floating up to the surface. And after that, we'll pack off it to get all the rest of the debris off the surface. To be painting, when we paint it and we seal it, we'll be using a LPH 300. We are using a color blender. It's a DBC 500 PBG product. And then we're using a slow reducer. We're using slow reducer because our booth will be sitting around at 90 degrees, which is 3 to 5 minute drive time, where regular is 5 to 10 minute drive time. And then we're using a sealer, which is we'll just fill in all our scratches that are sanding, which this will also help us do as well. And we'll do 3 coats of base, and we'll start out about two to three inches away from our patch repair spot, and then as we go through the coats, we'll come a little bit closer to the scratch repair spot. And we'll clear it 2 to 3 times just to get the OEM look back into it. And we'll use a different paint gun for that. We're using a Hiawatha clear coat gun. And then we will go sand. stain on them and it's getting away all the shiny spots. Just make it dull a little bit so all the paint sticks to it. And then when I spray it, I'm just looking for any more shiny spots to get rid of them. As you can see, like right in here and in the center and then in this corner, it's still pretty shiny, so we just have to get rid of those. Then I put our pad upside down. This way, don't get any dirt and debris on it to scratch our panel. there, Mom, grab some wax and degreaser just to make sure that we don't have any more shiny spots. Then I'm grabbing our white just so I can look closer at it, just to make sure there ain't no shiny spots in this white.
If you look like right here, there's a little bit, it's different color than here, so it's a little bit more shinier, so I just need to hit one more time, and it should be pretty good to go.
And we're looking pretty good. So we're going to bring it to the booth, turn on the booth, and then wax and grease it one more time and then tack cloth it.
Thank you.
Alright, so we're gonna mix our clear blend 1:1, and we're gonna paint the whole panel with this. So with this, we're gonna go to the 3 ounce mark and then the 6 ounce mark. Mix them together. And then again, it's like, since we're running at 90 degrees, it's only going to be 2 to 5 minutes setup time on this. Chunky or anything, you know, it's all mixed together. Pick up on it and make sure to see it all the way around. There she is. Put at 23 psi at our air nozzle. back, so when this machine goes, it runs through the whole gun. We're going to mix up our sealer, which is also a 1-to-1. This also just fills in all the cracks. Then with this, we're going to do 4 ounces, so we're going to go 2 and then 2. This we're just going to spray like an inch or two outside our patch repaired area. And if you notice when I sprayed the wall, I was just making sure that my fan was set correctly and I had enough volume coming out. This is also mixed 1-to-1. This is going to be our color. Doing 6 ounces with this as well, and it's also mixed 1-to-1. And then we're going to do 3 coats with this, and then we're going to go in there with that light to make sure I didn't miss any spots. another 2 coats.
Thank you.
sure we got full coverage. It's a 4-to-1 ratio, and we'll cover the whole panel. And we're going to the 6 mark right there, then the 6 mark right there. Then when we do the clear coat, we'll do the whole panel, and we're going to do 2 to 3 coats. Stuff is very stinky, so you don't want to be on your hands or clothing. also 2 to 3 minute, or 2 to 5 minute dry time as